afternoon.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
What is your name?
My name is Pranav Tripathi.
Where are you from?
I'm from Ghaziabad.
Do you work or are you a student?
I'm a student.
What is your favorite subject?
It's physics and maths.
Why it is your favorite?
Well, I have quite an interest in maths from childhood only. I like solving questions and calculation.
Okay, let's talk about birthdays. How do you celebrate your birthdays?
Nothing special. Go out with friends, eat, enjoy, dance maybe. Nothing special.
What kind of birthday gifts do you like to receive?
Well, my friends don't usually give many, but anything which is like anything related to food, I mean, chocolates, maybe something related to sports, like a football or a shoe which I need.
Okay. How do children celebrate their birthdays in your country?
Well, if they are young, like from very small, like from 1 to 6, then it's a house party, which they have no idea about. Usually it's friends of their parents only, cake cutting, and that's all. If someone of a teenage, he'll go out with his friends somewhere, eat out, maybe dance and in a club, that's all.
Okay, let's talk about punctuality. Do you like to be on time?
Well, yeah, everybody likes that, to be on time. But sometimes I'm late, so can't help it. But I try to be disciplined. It's really important.
How do you feel when others are late?
Depends. If there's urgent work, I feel irritated and late, and something is pending because of them. It's irritating.
Do you think it is important to be punctual?
Yeah, it's very important to be punctual and disciplined.
Why?
Well, it helps you to achieve your goals and learn something quicker. Like, if you have to do something, you have to be disciplined so that you can regularly work on that. Punctuality, discipline is important.
How do you remind yourself to be on time?
Then it will be a backlog for tomorrow, and then especially I'm a student, so I have to complete my syllabus or number of questions a day. If I don't do this today, then next day keep on adding up.
Okay, let's talk about indoor games. Do you play any indoor games?
Yeah, I play chess.
Do you prefer to play indoor or outdoor?
I play both. Like, I play football, chess, cricket. I play every sport, but usually football and chess.
What indoor games did you play when you were a child?
Well, I have played chess till national level, so I had played chess from very beginning only. But apart from chess, I have played Ludo and maybe some computer games, PlayStation and all.
Okay. What kind of video games do you like to play?
FIFA, maybe some action or God of War type.
Okay, let's talk about chocolate. How often do you eat chocolate?
Well, almost twice a day. When I'm studying, I usually have a chocolate.
What is your favorite?
I have a favorite chocolate as such. I can have any chocolate, but if I get a preference, then it will be Kit Kat.
Is chocolate expensive in your country?
Depends on the chocolate you're buying. Usually not.
When was the first time you ate chocolate?
As far as I can remember, it will be when I was around 1 or 2.
Okay, let's talk about books. Do you have many books at home?
If you're like related to study or academic, yeah, a lot. But apart from that, novels or fiction, I read them, but not quite. I don't get much time apart from the studies.
Okay. Do Indian people do enough reading?
People around me do. Well, my friends and my family, they read a lot. They all love reading, so I guess yes.
What kind of books children read nowadays?
Every book which is of no use, any story random which is famous, they read anything.
Do you think children have lost their interest in stories?
Book stories, yeah, but if it's a gossip or something related to your friends, everybody wants to know. They don't want to read stories before going to sleep.
Can storybooks be an ideal gift for children?
Yes. A children of for my age, no. But for
what
someone,
about young children?
If they are too young, then it's of no mean because they can't read. But if they are around 8 or 10, then yeah, maybe yes, it can be a good idea.
Okay, let's talk about art. Do you like art?
No, I'm not good at it. Not at all, like painting.
Do you think art classes are necessary and why?
I won't say it is necessary, but if somebody likes it, then yeah, he should have an opportunity for learning it. So yeah, it can be a class. There should be a availability, but it not should be a necessary.
What kind of paintings do Indian people like?
I have no idea because I really don't like paintings, but maybe normal pictures of their family and friends, you know, which you can use at home.
All right, now I will give you your 2-minute topic. You will have 1 minute to prepare on that topic and you have to speak for 1 to 2 minutes, fine? Describe a new public building you want to visit. What is the building, where and when was it built? Why do you want to visit it? You have 1 minute.
Shall I start?
Yes.
The building I would like to visit is the Chess Museum, which is jointly built in Delhi. Right. Because I really wanted to visit something related to chess, but in India there was nothing much, like no museum or anything. I remember when I used to play chess, I had a lot of troubles because there were not many places where there could be international games or national level games. So I really wanted to visit that museum. And that museum has all the world champion statues and the games they have played, all the great games in the chess history. Also that it includes lots of international exhibitions of international players. So there's a lot to learn about chess. And also due to this, my 12th board exam, I was not able to continue with my chess. So it will be a great fun to be there and meet my friends and all the coaches I have worked with. Also that there's all the games which I always wanted to watch in life, and also the players I wanted to talk to. Yeah, that is the place I would really like to go. But it's really of what I like, chess, and also that it has all the things I've always wanted to. Because as a chess player, it was always a problem. So the game was not very popular. And also I had to travel a lot. So it will be great to see that now there is something for chess. The facility is there.
Okay, what kind of building is that?
It's a chess museum. It's of two floors, I guess. And in the first floor, it has all the playing area and the statues of all the world champions till now and about them information and the games they have, the best games they have played. The second floor, it's more of a coaching where you can learn chess, and I guess it has all the canteen necessary which a chess player requires.
What types of buildings are there in your hometown?
In my hometown, my hometown is Nainital, so there are not many buildings, so it's a hillside. But it has a library, a small cinema, shopping complex, which is not very big, and some food stalls and all.
Is it good trend to have skyscrapers in the city?
it has both its benefits and losses, but yeah, it's necessary because the population is so much that there has to be space for everyone to live, and nowadays everybody wants facilities, swimming pools and everything in the societies, so it's necessary. But also for the environment, it's a big loss because creating such big skyscrapers includes a lot of things, especially the pollution it causes. So it also has its side effects.
Okay, do you think buildings' shapes and structures will change in future?
Yeah, definitely. Because the population is increasing so much and the area we have is not much. So they have to change in technology somehow. Maybe structures, maybe anything. They have to build so that there can be more population in the same area, more beneficial, more economical also, because the resources are, you know, ending, so they have to change something somehow.
Would you like to live in a different shaped building, round or triangular, and if yes, why?
No, it will be a no. I think it's too risky. It's safe to be where I am right now, so I won't want to change that.
All right, this is the end of your speaking. Thank you.
Thank you.